Hurricane Sandy led our news bulletins night after night at the end of October. It brought devastation and misery to millions of Americans, and it also brought heartbreak to 12 Pacifica women who had pinned their hopes on the Big Apple.
Team Pacifica started training 2 years ago for the New York Marathon, but it was cancelled after the superstorm, the first time in its 42-year history.
Our very own Sandra Kailahi is a part of Team Pacifica and brings you the journey of her fellow teammates.
It all began with a goal to get fit and lose weight. A group of women from the organisation Pacifica exercising outside with trainer Tremaine Brickhouse.
Just imagine, that's functional. Keep it up, let's go.
Then came a bigger goal. Why not run the New York Marathon?
I like to take something on. I have a bucket list and the New York Marathon is on that list. But I think for me it's quite meaningful to be able to do it with some of my best friends.
Definitely something that I didn't want to do. But now that I'm into the training, I'm looking forward to it.
Gives me a goal, something to train for. And if ever I'm going to do a marathon, I would want to do it with this group.
And who better to give advice than broadcaster and author Kerry Woodham, who wrote Short Fat Chick to Marathon Runner.
For me, because I've always been such a slacker, to set a goal, train for it and achieve it was one of the most empowering things I've ever done.
So after the inspirational talk, 12 brave souls who make up Team Pacifica started training at the beginning of this year for the 42.2-kilometre race. That included two gym sessions a week and group running sessions, which started off with just two-minute runs and after 8 months reached over 32 kilometres. For each of the women, doing the race meant different things.
It's always been a goal of mine for 20, 30 years, perhaps when I was a lot fitter and a lot younger, and it's funny that we're doing it now when we're a lot older, a lot heavier and...
You know, heaps of my friends have done it and they've said it's, you know, it's got such a great atmosphere. So I just wanted to be part of that and do it with people that are friends and family.
I really wanted to push myself to do it, so the motivation came from just this sheer stubbornness of knowing that I was going to finish.
Anything can happen.
Anything can happen.
So I'm
going to
beat you.
She's a cheeky little sister, but that's all right. I'm used to it.
Team Pacifica also took on running coach Matt Lewisham.
So for me, I have it vibrating every 20 minutes saying have some food and water.
Matt helped the women with a running schedule as well as a game plan, taking them right up to the marathon. And that game plan had lots of early morning starts.
Doing the runs in the morning, it takes a lot out of me. Don't enjoy it, but got to do it.
4 months out from the marathon, the women have followed Matt's running schedule almost to the T, clocking up some big distances.
I've trusted Matt and the plan, and I think that if you just stick to the plan, anything's possible.
Just coming up to an hour's run, I've lost 10 kilos. Since we first started, my goal was to do 5 kilometres easily in 40 minutes, and I've achieved that.
Naz, how far did you go?
Well done, darling.
24.
Woo!
Well done.
24. Oh, my gosh. How are you feeling after 24?
Awesome. Oh, my goodness.
It's now a couple of weeks to the marathon and training is starting to wind down. But along with the excitement is frustration for some of the women.
We just completed 2 half marathons, you know, running non-stop, and that was really exciting. And we did it as a group, which was really great. And when I fell, it took a lot out of me.
I've been diagnosed with tendonitis, and so obviously I'm sporting an injury on my ITBs and the thighs and the knee area. So lots of physio work has been put in to try and get it right before the run.
I actually had a knee injury due to tramping. And so I've got, I had a torn meniscus lateral. So I actually had to have that operated on. And it's just being able to get back into running again. So, yeah, it has been a challenge.
But the biggest challenge, which no one saw coming, was from Mother Nature.
The biggest storm in decades to lash America's most densely populated region.
The latest death toll we have is at least 45, with the damage estimated to cost tens of billions of dollars. and hurricane-turned-superstorm Sandy isn't finished yet.
There was a lot of angst about whether to go to New York, but on the Wednesday before the marathon, the mayor declared it would still go ahead. So Team Pacifica hit the Big Apple, staying close to Times Square, which wasn't affected by Hurricane Sandy. And the first official stop, the registration expo to pick up the New York Marathon goodies. And there was even a photo op with a familiar face from home, former Prime Minister Helen Clark, who now works for the United Nations. But the good times were about to end. 2 days before the marathon, this devastating announcement.
So it only makes sense, given the uncertainties of this and the pressure on services in Manhattan and the discomfiture of the people there, don't do the marathon.
A little bit pissed off, just to put it mildly. Understood the decision, but it was just all about timing, you know. If it happened sooner, we could have readjusted and rebooked and changed a lot of things, but we couldn't.
There's other marathons to run back in New Zealand and other places in the world, so New York was going to be a good one to do your very first one in, but obviously it wasn't meant to be.
Totally gutted. And I felt guilty about feeling gutted, because at a human level, I completely understand why it should be called off, and that people cannot be supporting an event like this when they're just trying to survive and put their lives together.
So after 2 years in the making, a superstorm and the cancellation of the marathon, Team Pacifica was down but not defeated. Most of the women decided to still run in New York.
We did run, eventually, with Team Pacifica at Central Park, and I thought, this is like a warm-up again. When is this warm-up going to stop, you know? But I went down there, you know, my heart a bit heavy, but when I got down there, there was thousands of other runners from other countries, and it was just fantastic, and it was just so neat to be around it. And I was thinking, this is what it would have been like. So, yeah, so I actually walked that day, yeah.
I'm going to run anyway, and I'm really looking forward to that, but I might even pin my number on there just just for effect, but it's really just about achieving what I came here to do.
I came here to do 42.2 kilometres, and I just feel that my body is ready for it.
I said to my sister, you know, we've come all this way, we've just got to continue and keep on doing this marathon. We've just got to run and do the distance. We're just going to keep passing all the different milestones that we had, because we had a reason for running yesterday. We dedicate it to our auntie.
The question now, will Team Pacifica return to New York for the 2013 marathon? That is still being worked out with the organisers, but the women have decided not to give up and are going to carry on with their running.